And next important thing, what is the thing we are going to discuss today is advantages and disadvantages of scatter diagram. Now only we have come across what is only scatter diagram. Now what is the thing we are going to see is first one advantages and next one disadvantages of scatter diagram. Advantages of scatter diagram can be classified under three important thing. What are the three important thing? Means first one, it is a simple and non-mathematical method. It is very easy to calculate. It does not use more mathematical terms. So it is a very easiest one. Second important thing, not influenced by the size of the extreme item. Suppose we just collect the information about population, poverty, unemployment, level of literacy, each and everything. It does not affect each and every term. So what is the thing? Not influenced by the size of the extreme item. This is the second important advantages. Third important advantage, it is the first important set, it is the first important procedure and setup for to study the relationship between two or more variables. Clear? These are all the three important advantages of scatter diagram. Oh wow. Now what is the thing we are going to see today is next one, disadvantages of scatter diagram. Disadvantages of scatter diagram means it cannot establish the exact degree of correlation. Either it is a positive correlation or it is a negative correlation or it is a high degree or it is a low degree or it is a no correlation. Each and everything, it cannot be understood in a perfect nature whenever and wherever we are studied. So it is the main important disadvantage of this method. Oh wow. And next important thing, what is the thing we are going to discuss today is graphic method. Graphic method, you people know very well. Here the individual values of any two thing, any two variables we just take into account. For example, the two values we just take into account, x and y, we are just taken into account, and we can also plot at each and every point on a graph shape, and we are studying the relationship, we can call it as it is a graphic method. Graphic method, we are having two important things, positive correlation and another one negative correlation. If two variables, it will move in the same direction, we can call it as it is a positive correlation under graphic method. And under graphic method, we are having another important thing, negative correlation means it is nothing but one variable it will be increases, another one variable it will be come down, now we can call it as it is a negative correlation. Oh wow. Next one, third important method of studying correlation, Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. This Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it was introduced by Pearson's coefficient. Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it was introduced by Carl Pearson, and it was also explained by the main important symbol R. It also shows the relationship between two variables. What are the two variables? Means x and y. Another important thing, Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it was also popularly known as Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it is always lies between the values plus 1 and minus 1. Clear? And what are the main important thing? Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it is also denoted by the symbol R. It also shows the relationship between two variables x and y. Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it was introduced by the statistician Carl Pearson. Clear? And next important thing, very very important thing, this Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation carry part D 5 marks. Very very important thing, listen very carefully, easy to understand also. Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, it is explained by the formula R equals n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y by root of n sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square into n sigma y square minus sigma y the whole square. This is the formula. Is it clear? And what are the values they have given in the question? X values they have given and y values they have given in the question. For this x and y value, we have to calculate Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. So they have given already two things, x values they have given, y values they have given. So what is the new thing we have to calculate now? Three column we have to calculate. First one xy, next one x square, next one y square. XY means it is nothing but each x value, it should be multiplied with y value. We are getting one thing that we can call it as it is a XY. 10 into 40, 400. 12 into 41, 492. 14 into 48, 672. 15 into 60, 900. Using a calculator, you can do each and everything. It's very, very easy. Listen very carefully. Or you can know the calculation, you can tell of your own itself. 19 into 50, 950. Is clear? So this is the xy. Another one, x square means each and every x values you have to multiply with the same number, it should be multiplied. 10 into 10, 10 tens are 100. 12 twelves are 144. 14 fourteens are 196. 15 fifteens are 225. 19 into 19, 361. Clear? And next one, y square means each and every y values it should be square. 40 into 40, 1600. 41 into 41, 1681. Next one, 48 into 48, 2304. 60 into 60, 3600. 50 into 50, 2500. So what are the things we have calculated? XY over, X square over, Y square over. Each and every values total we have to take into account. We want what are the things? Sigma XY we want, so we have to calculate this one. X square we want, so we have to total this one. Y square we want, so we have to total this one. Sigma X total we want, we have to total. So each and every column wise we have to make a total for each and everything. Wait. Sigma x total, 10 plus 12 plus 14 plus 15 plus 19, what is the answer we are getting? 70. 40, 41, 48, 60, 50, each and everything you are added now, 239. 400, 492, each and every xy values you are added now, 3414. Each and every x square values we can add at 100, 144, 196, 225 plus 361 we are added now. What is the answer we are getting? 1026. And likewise, y square, 1600, 1681, 2304, 3600, 2500, each and every values we added now, 11,685. Each and every values we are getting. Clear? Now what is the thing? Simply we are just applying the formula and we are going to calculate, we are getting the answer. N means it is nothing but number of values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wherever you can check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear? So n means it is nothing but 5. Sigma xy. What is the xy column total? 3414. 3414 minus sigma x. X column total, what is the answer we are getting? 70. Into sigma y. Y column total? 239. By root of n sigma x square. N means what? How many values we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And x square, sigma x square, what is the total? 1026. Minus sigma x the total, 70 the square. Into n sigma y square, 5 into sigma y square total, 11,685. Minus sigma y the whole square, sigma y total 239. Clear? So what is the thing you have to do now? Immediately we have to do, what is the thing? 5 into 3414. You have to multiply these two values. And another thing, you have to multiply these two values. You are getting one number, you have to write this one. So what is the thing? 5 into 3414, wait. So 5 into 3414 we are multiplying now. We are getting what is answer now? 17070 minus 70 into 239. What is answer we are getting? 16,730 divided by root of 5 into 1026. What is answer we are getting? 5130 minus 70 the whole square. What is answer we are getting? 4900. You have to put bracket. Clear? Next one. 5 into 11685. What is the answer we are getting? 58,425 minus 239 the whole square. What is answer? 57121. Is it clear? These are all the values. So these two numbers we have to subtract. 170 minus 16730 we are subtract. Now what is answer? We are getting 340. It should be divided by 5130 minus 4900. What is answer we are getting here? Yes, 230. What is answer we are getting? 230 into 58425 minus 57121. We can, what is answer we are getting now? 1304. Over. Yeah, I am not having space, so only I just write each and everything here. So again you have to write 340 divided by root of, what is the thing we are having now? 230 into 1304. You have to multiply. What are the things? 230, it should be multiplied with 130 for now. What is answer we are getting now? 299,920. So again you have to write 340 by, you are taking the root for 299,920. You are getting root now. What is answer we are getting now? 547.649. So you just divide these two number. 340 divided by 547.649. You are just using calculator now. What is the R value you are getting now? 0.621. That's all. So R values is always lies between positive 1 to plus 1. Clear? And that's the end of the class. Take care all. Thank you. And we will see the remaining things in the next class.